me is here. So let's give a welcome to Chong Hui. 谢谢。之前的两届 Globation 我已经用过两年的英文演讲，所以决定第三次参加的时候我必须要转换成汉语文化 Mandarin。So for the overseas foreigners, I will try to translate my Mandarin for the keynote. 关于今天这个演讲呢，其实我最开始提交的是叫做 What we do on promoting free open source in China。在最开始提交的时候呢，我提交完了就发现一个问题，也是最近这段时间发现的问题，就是我少了一个非常重要的一个词，就是 should。我们必须要做这件事情，而不是说可做可不做。所以我就把 should 这个词又加上了，然后特意加了一层可爱的一个蓝猫的标签，表示我们必须要做这件事情。当然这个蓝猫的标签是有背景含义的，这个其实是Gnome 的 Artwork 这个组在做的一个工作，大家做一些很多这种小的 icon， 就可爱。我比较喜欢的这个 icon 是一个小包，同时呢还有比较喜欢的就是我喜欢在这个语词当中加入一个我原先应该加入的词。为什么我说在中国推广是必须要做的，而且我们要怎么去必须要做这件事情，也是我后面要去打算去考虑的和去完善的一个问题。先来做一下我自我介绍。我是 Gnome 这个基金会的成员，已经是三年了，然后在同时也是北京 Gnome User Group 的这个成员。这个时间其实比基金会成员长，我从2010年开始就是北京 Gnome 的成员。然后是我现在的一个公职呢，是在 CSDN 作为开源的一个推广者之间。在整个这个环境过程当中，在中国这个大环境过程当中，其实还有很多很多我们需要做的事情。那么我作为一个推广者，其实以前一直在做一个工作，并不是一个推广者，而是一个做软件开发、硬件开发的人。其实以前是在做硬件开发，做了很多硬件开发以后呢，就发现一个问题，就是我们需要做的工作不是一个技术工作，很可能是一个人的问题。对了，刚才在另外一个 session 在刚才一个台湾的一个 Frank 他那边就说，人的问题是关键，技术问题还很好办。那么在我意识到这些问题以后呢，我在和其他人去交流，那么就交流到了很多的东西。所以咱们就来先做这么一个问题，咱们先来去讨论一下，我们如何去做。同时还有一个非常重要的问题，就是我们如何面对一些问题，就是我面对哪些问题，面对哪些我会碰上的问题。那么在这一个演讲过程当中呢，在先讲后讨论，而我们把讨论放在这里。那么请到我吧，然后请大家呢自愿分成四个组，我们做一些内部一个小的讨论。每个人会拿到一张纸，然后用写下你觉得我们在中国推广开源的时候遇到哪些问题，你怎么解决。非常简单，一张纸，上面是问题，下面是解决。把问题和解决方案列出来的时候，我们要做的工作就已经很有意思了。请。
要不我们现在是相当于这个教室太大了，实际上我们要小一个教室能够好一点。然后其实同会呢，它准备了很多笔，然后要不然前面这个2、3、4、5、6、7的，然后到前面来，然后后面的是后面那一组，然后这边呢是一组，然后一共三组，好。然后那个我们就是每一组呢，我们会。然后我用英文翻译一下。This conference room is to be a workshop. We today want to discuss how to promote a force in China. And I think the matter by Chinese or foreigners, you still have lots of ideas. So we want to put people into three different groups. People who are sitting in the front. You are team A, and in the end are team B, and in that part you are team C, and I will help to coordinate. So team A people come to here, you have voices. I think that you have many ideas to share with people how to promote force in China, and even more in Asia.
可以写下大家觉得你要我们面对哪些问题，还有怎么去解决你的一些想法，任何一些想法都可以，我们一起来为中国的开源出谋划策。 到啊，咱们下面就请每一组啊 ，team by team， 就是每一组的组长啊，咱们的 leader， 然后做一个简单的啊一到两分钟的讲一下你找到的问题以及它的解决方案。首先呢，请咱们第一组啊 ，A 组 team A please， hi please， yeah hurry 够场 team A。
Hello, everybody. My name is Harris. We worked on about two problems. I think two problems is complex. The first thing is about open source use is in school. Not many school using open source software. Most of them using non-free software. And school also teach a specific application. For example, the school teach how to use Microsoft Word, not teaching about how to write in your computer, how to print out, how to make some letter. They're teaching about specific application. The other one is no company support. It's example for in Indonesia. If the school or the government migrate to using open source software, they will difficult to find which company can support them. So if we give the suggestion, use the community to support, they doesn't leave the community because they have no legal issue. So we also write the solution for school. School or university, sometimes we must promote the open source or new free software. So someone, we are most going to university, maybe cooperate with some vendor that close to open source software, for example, the Nokia maybe or the Mozilla Foundation. We have some workshop, for example, we already training Nokia and Mozilla Foundation in Indonesia. We come to some university and we have workshop how to build an application for Mozilla Firefox. But we bring Linux. We use, for example, Blank One OS or Ubuntu system or Fedora. We have also bring live CD and give to the participant. Use this for building an application. Try this first. And after that, they will just care about the OS anymore. But we're already doing everything. So the point in university maybe teach them open source and Linux as a tool to provide them how to do their job. Not a religion or lifestyle, maybe. At the university. Or school, maybe Eric can explain more. But actually, I never go to university, really. I only graduated from high school. And the other one about company and government, actually. The main problem of open source in some country or city is the government issue and the company. For example, in 2008, starting from 2007, I tried to migrate one city in Indonesia to using open source software. It's quite very difficult because the government doesn't care about what is open source software. They just know the staff, the government staff can write the letter and do their job every day. But we found one leader in that one city that lived the spirit of free software and open source. So we make a legal agreement. At that time, I worked at some NGO, right down there, and my office support all the budget to migrate. And in 2010, we already migrated less than 8,000 computers. We have a big effort because we must have a training for the government staff, starting from that. And the other, we also support the two schools, only we choose the best school to learning about it and also teaching the teacher. But after that, all the schools follow using open source software. It's because the best school already used and the government already used. And they hope that if the school or the small university at that city, they feel that if the student graduated, they can have a job in the government, and the government using open source software. Another city, like in Jakarta, the capital city, now mostly all people doesn't care about open source. They only know they can put a lot of application. So I give up in Jakarta. I don't want to promote open source software in Jakarta, but another city is okay. I have another strategy. Me and some of my friends built some small companies. But we only accept an employer only if he able or she able to use Linux. The first test is how to install Linux. Yeah. The other hand, I always ask about this philosophy about open source software. I don't get if he's smart or not smart, but the first thing is he able to use Linux and open source software.
So you use force?
Yeah,
you
sometimes
force, so
force power is needed. Yeah. Sometimes it's tough on me.
Okay, so okay.
One thing. And the other, we only accept job if the job is in open source and we will release in open source software. For example, now I already finishing my job, actually not finishing yet, because it's until 2008 maybe the project. We creating an online office for the government in Indonesia. All the government staff in Indonesia, about 4 million government staff will use that application, and the application will be putting on GitHub maybe next week. Already released, but only in government staff, but I already asked that it will be using the GitHub. So we have a job using open source. We also contribute an application in open source software. That's exactly. So people will know, or maybe the community of the student will know that being a people in open source now is also being the open source people also make you rich, for example. You can have a BMW if you're using open source software. I already proved it. I have BMW because of open source software.
Okay, thank you. Okay. Team B. Oh, yeah. This is the first team. 请这个黄总来讲。
Hi everybody. I think there is lots of people here who want to say something, so I want to be brief. So the first problem is I think the state-sponsored censorship would be the center of the problem of affects the open source community. Because we don't encounter that kind of problem that the GitHub or SourceForge or some open source website being blocked by the state-sponsored Great Firewall. And I think the solution would be, or we should advocate the use of circumvent the Great Firewall, which would be quite famous, and that's the first problem. The second problem is there is huge amount of electronic devices like router and tablet and mobile phone. They all use the proprietary driver, and they didn't resource any source code, so made it impossible for us to replace the stock firmware with some open source outdated like the CNO, Gym, or OpenWRT. Currently, there is no way that we can sue this company in China. So I think the Chinese legal system should be changed in some way. So the open source can be more in China.
Oh, 谢谢. 然后请第三组 TC.
Write the keynote down so you can read the words. My pronunciation may be not good enough. My first problem is how to not using privacy. The first lesson is provide more second problem is
attract some
more young developer.
More young developer from university. Same as Kim A. Yeah. For the future for developer. And the third one is FSF lag. Like.
Let them use first. Use first.
traditional culture, redefined traditional culture to fit the free and open source culture. OK, 非常感谢这个。
Maybe that the we need person. We need a strong person in China.
Very 感谢三个小组，非常感谢三个小组的这个组长。这个实际上呢，我在准备这个投影的时候，我也写过这样一个 paper。那么我的问题和 solve 是怎么样的呢？就是我其实无意当中发现和大家的这个想法非常吻合。problem 就是我遇到的问题，就是第一个，比如说 no freedom， 我们在推广开源的时候会发现，开源背后的自由被阉割掉了，没有了，这是很严重的问题。No freedom。 然后一个就是这个 independent integrity， 刚才这个 Team C 也提到了，就是所谓的自主知识产权的问题，我们如何去将知识产权的概念更加深入人心。第三个就是没有更多的开发者，刚才其实很多的大家就几乎三个组都提到了没有开发者的问题，还有就是一些没有开源文化，刚才也是 Team C 也提到了没有开源文化。最后一个就是也没有更多的学生，哪怕有更多的学生也好，没有那么多，但是这方面的学生也学得少，学校里也不教。那么就像刚才印度尼西亚这位同学这位先生碰到的问题是一模一样的，就是我们没有更多的学生。可以从这一点上来发现，我几乎经常都是亚洲的国家在面对同样问题的时候产生的问题几乎相同，就无形当中我们就像三国里面草船借箭那个动作一样，就大家无形当中想到了一起。那么既然有这个问题，我们怎么去解决呢？那么解决的途径，比如说先拿出一个比较大家现在正在感受到的，就是葛东美闪和北京葛东用户组在做的一些努力。一个是征询这个各种高校的志愿者，咱们这次葛东美闪大会的所有的志愿者都是高校学生，几乎都是高校学生，所以这是我们很成功的一点，就是高校学生的志愿者。然后呢，我们还有一个非常重要的一点，就是从对葛东这个项目的本地化开始入手，这个方式相对来说比较简单，也比较容易操作。那么还有一些就是更好去鼓励女性参与，因为在亚洲女性参与是一个非常弱的地方，那么我们通过这样一种方式来鼓励女性参与，这也是能够聚拢更多的人气的一种非常好的地方。另外就是因为社区又非常小，我们就与其他的一些社区一起来办活动，一起来完成一些我们需要做的工作。那么可以看到，那么这些就是我们其实在做的一些工作，可以看到有很多女性参加，又有一些很好的活动，我们这做得不错。那么但是它其实有一些问题呢，其实前面我们说到了这些问题，它其实并没有完全解决掉。我可以解决到 university 的问题，但是我没法解决掉它和企业的联系的问题，没法解决掉更多的开发者、更多的贡献者的问题。它的贡献还是它的实际上并不是说解决了问题，而是把这个问题相对来说容易去控制。那么还有一种解决方法，就是我现在供职的 Setting Code 这个平台在做一些方法啊，非常意外的是，我们 Code 平台的这个产品经理也坐在后面。大家如果有空的话，可以一起往来交流一下。那么 Code 呢，首先是有一个这个 Code 平台。Code 平台是个什么东西？是一个这个 Hypernews 里说的是 GitHub Like， 我把它说的是非 GitHub Like， 就是什么意思？它不是一个完全的一个 GitHub Like 的一个托管平台，它更多的还包括很多的服务功能。它是一个完整的服务功能，它的服务功能GitHub 的一个代码功能，还包括像 Code、像文档，我们有非常强的文档项目，可以去做非常好的这种文档交互，当时都面向开发者。还有一些像这个自由软件方面啊，开源方面的一些新闻，都在上面。还有像后面我们已经上线的这个学长系统，可以通过企业去更好的和贡献者、开发者联系在一起，以及一个开源的项目，马上即将上线的开源项目，当然还会有更多。那么这样做的目的就是，除了解决一个高校的问题，解决企业的问题，就基本上可以同时解决这些同样所有问题的同时。但是，这个但是很重要。这是现在这个 Setting Code 的一个 为首页，就是一个非常重要的要求，就是一个标准，就是一站式攀援服务，为所有人搭建一个服务的平台。但是呢，有这么一个问题，就是它其实还是不够什么专业，不够好，所以我们就有一个攀援项目的一个计划，啊，这是一个像 Google Summer Code 的一个相似的东西，啊，就是一个由导师攀援社区导师去指导学生去完成一个攀援项目的一个做法，非常简单，非常好，非常容易。然后呢，但是所有都是开源的，然后导师和学生一对一交流，啊，直接交流，这跟 Google Summer Code 其实是一样的，但不同的是它更容易引入参加，引入咱们社区去参加进去。当然这会很快会上线，那它的主要目的其实非常简单，就是为了让学生更好地参加到社区当中，更好地为社区做贡献。那么但是很重要，它能不能够解决最终的问题现在还不好说。其实我们很多面临的问题更多的来自于像刚才说的政治问题中，这个问题我们还没有直接的解决方案，但是我们在动作，就是在去做这个工作。所以为什么要去做，因为这是一个我们必须要做的工作，What we should do， 就在这我们必须要去做的工作。其实刚才我谈到两种方案，一种是社区方案，社区方案方法，还有一种是公司的方法。两种方法，各位更喜欢哪个呢？欢迎咱们这个一起来交流。好了，谢谢大家。今天就不设 Q&A 的环节了，咱们先线下来交流。